a major concession from TransCanada. This is the owner of the Keystone pipeline. It will now reroute the pipeline around some sensitive areas in Nebraska. Is this enough to save the project and tens of thousands of jobs it'll create? Let's ask Congressman Lee Terry of Nebraska, who played a big role in this deal. Well, congratulations, I guess, Congressman, but it all depends on whether the White House is good with it. Have you heard from them at all?
No, I haven't heard from them, and you're absolutely right. The ultimate decision still lies with the White House, but this is a path forward to get the Keystone Pipeline built. It's thousands of construction jobs in Nebraska, increased property values, and permanent employees of the pipeline in Nebraska. So I'm pretty enthusiastic about this new move.
Now, are all Nebraskans or those Nebraskans that were against the pipeline going through these areas, are they good with the move?
Well, there was a significant portion of those opposed that were opposed to it going over the aquifer, the sensitive part of Nebraska. They have said, or at least the governor and the legislators that were concerned about it, they're great with the pipeline where it's going to be proposed off of the aquifer. So it's only the, you know, Sierra Club, the Daryl Hannahs that were out protesting that are still going to be against it.
What about the governor? The governor is a Republican, we should mention, the Nebraska governor, George Heineman. He was against it where it was being built. Is he now for it?
Governor Heineman's position has been move it off the aquifer. This resolves his issue and many others that were concerned about the ecosystem and the aquifer. He was part of the negotiations and has signed off on them, just like the speaker of our legislature has.
Now, the president continues to claim that it's not his decision, it's the State Department's call. Do you believe that?
As I understand the law, the State Department makes a recommendation. If they say recommend it and he doesn't do anything, I guess the State Department will go forward with it. But it's called a presidential order because the president has to sign it. So I don't know how he gets away without signing it, yes or no.
As you know, I'm sure, that the president is sort of caught between two supporting groups, one the unions and the other the environmentalists. How heavily are those two groups lobbying, and in what way?
Oh, they're both going at it. They're heavyweights in the middle of the ring. The reality, though, I think that the move, TransCanada's move to move it off of a sensitive area of our ecosystem in Nebraska, takes away the environmental issue. So it only leaves the extremists behind that just want to kill all fossil fuels. So it really lessens the amount of people in the opposition because of environment pool.
Now,
Those people, the labor unions, man, they really want these jobs and they deserve them.
The question is, will the Canadians wait long enough as it takes to reroute the thing, which could take at least another year? Do they have the patience to wait for that, or are they going to ship the oil to China?
Boy, I pray they have the patience, because our energy security is really dependent on this pipeline being built. According to the governor's office, part of the timeline here is that the re-siting and environmental study will be done in 6 months. And then it's going to be up to the State Department. We're going to look at ways perhaps that we can do another piece of legislation here to set a timeline for the State Department to make their recommendation.
Congressman Lee Terry, good to see you, Congressman. Congratulations.
Hey, thank you.
Somewhat of a deal, at any rate. Thank you.